Hey folks, this is Soapbox here. Today we'll be looking at the Coyote missiles to answer the question, do these missiles suck? For people who don't know what Coyote missiles are, they are a dumbfire missile that will lock on if they get close enough to enemy aircraft. Before I start, I want to let you know that the Coyote missiles hold 6 missiles per clip, as I'll be referencing to this throughout the course of the video. To purchase this weapon, it'll cost you 1,000 certs or 700 station cash. Each faction owns their own version of the Coyote missile. This means if you buy the Vanu version of the Coyote missile with station cash, they'll be unlocked for all your Vanu characters across your account. Same goes for NC or TR. Personally, I think it should be a nanite system weapon, so they will be unlocked for every character across your account if you choose to purchase it with station cash. For each faction to have their own Coyote missile is quite pointless and a waste of our time and money. To start us off, let's go over the damage model. Each missile will deal 100 damage upon hitting its turret. The interesting thing is that it has an indirect damage of 200 within 0.35 of a meter, and then drops off to 1 damage out at 3 meters. This allows for the weapon to still take out ground targets without being overpowered when facing off against air. I did some in-game testing to see the damage of the weapon and got some interesting results. It takes 24 missiles, which is 4 full clips to kill an ESF from full health. A lightning will take 36 missiles, which is 6 full clips to kill, assuming all shots land in the rear of the tank. And a standard infantry will take 4 direct shots to kill. As you can see, the statistics are a little off, but my in-game testing is right, so you can trust that. 24 missiles is quite a bit to kill an ESF, so they're definitely a supplement to your main gun. The next concern is the lock-on range. There are no official stats for the lock-on range, but it seems if the missiles get within 10 meters of the center of the vehicle, they will lock on. They will lock on the same place that a standard anti-air rocket will lock onto. Since it locks onto the middle of the vehicle, there's a visual deception while shooting this weapon. Even if you aim for the head or tail of an aircraft, you may still miss. This is especially prevalent in Galaxies and Liberators as they are so big. So, this is just something to keep in mind while using this weapon. Also, the missiles are able to change direction at a moment's notice. So, they can be flying straight and then pass 10 meters above an aircraft and make a 90 degrees turn to hit the aircraft. This definitely makes them a much more feasible weapon in the battlefield. One last note is that decoy flares will break any locks and prevent any new locks from Coyote missiles until the flares run out. This is standard for decoy flares, but I thought I should mention it. A very interesting trait with Coyote missiles is that they fire from the belly of the aircraft. While it does look like they're coming out of the nose of the aircraft, they are technically coming from the underbelly. This allows for some very interesting gameplay. If you are within 10 meters while flying over an enemy aircraft and shooting your missiles, then your missiles will turn straight down and hit the enemy aircraft. This is great if you are often dogfighting close ranges, because you don't even need to be able to see the target to deal damage, as long as you know they're close enough to be locked onto. This is by far the best feature of the Coyote missiles. Another interesting thing about these missiles is that they suffer from a vertical drop over time, much like bullets will. This makes it especially hard to aim while shooting over longer ranges. The missiles seem to drop from the middle of your crosshair to the first circle in the crosshair in about 4 to 5 seconds due to the cone of fire. I apologize for the lack of hard data here, but there's only so much testing I can do by myself with my limited resources. As you work more with this weapon, you'll get a feeling for the drop and be able to compensate for it. This brings us to our next topic, which is the cone of fire. Again, unlike most missiles or rockets, the Coyote missiles have a cone of fire. This means that the missiles will shoot higher or lower than the others, or more left to right. While in most cases this is not noticeable, it does become more relevant as the distance from your target increases. When it comes to muzzle velocity, the Coyote missiles fire at 150 meters per second. While this is much faster than any plane can fly, it is still slow and one of the downsides of this weapon. In comparison, it is slightly faster than any other rocket launchers or air-to-air missiles, but it's almost half the speed of air-to-ground missiles. As stated earlier, each clip holds 6 rockets and holds a default of 48 rounds in reserve. While the clip size cannot be increased, the rounds in reserve can. Oddly, when you land at ammo pads, you restock at 12 missiles at a time, rather than the normal clip size of 6. And when it comes to reload speed, it'll take you 4 seconds to reload the clip no matter what. As far as actually shooting the weapon, the Coyote missiles have a rate of fire that clocks in at 400 rounds per minute. This means you'll be able to fire a whole clip in just under 1 second. If you couple this with the reload speed, then it'll mean that it takes 5 seconds from the time the first missile leaves the aircraft until the weapon is reloaded and ready to shoot again. When it comes to attachments, the Coyote missile has access to scopes 1.5x through 2x with night vision and thermal optics. My personal favorite is the normal scope, but truly it doesn't matter much on this weapon. In the utility slot, there's only one option, which is reload speed, which at max rank decreases the time to reload by 1 second. As I stated earlier, this is the only available upgrade, so I would of course recommend doing this. And lastly, in the ammo slot, you have ammo capacity, which will increase your max capacity by 60 rounds when the certification line is maxed out. While this weapon is not that appealing stat-wise, it does perform very differently in-game. The Coyote missiles are excellent when you're dogfighting in close ranges. The best part is that you don't even need to wait for the lock-on. Rather, you can just fire the missiles and have them lock on when they get close. This is great because you often don't have time to lock on when you're fighting up close, and these will eliminate that need. Another great thing that I touched on earlier is the fact that the missiles originate from the belly of the aircraft. This lets you damage targets that would normally be out of reach from your nose gun. This is especially useful if your dogfights often end up in spirals, or if you and the other aircraft charge each other. The biggest problem is its ability to deal damage to air, especially when compared to normal air-to-air missiles. It'll take 8.5 missiles to equal the same damage as one air-to-air rocket. Also, the Coyote missiles shoot at 6 missiles at a time, with a 4 seconds to reload in between. This gives the enemy air a chance to repair or run away between rounds. Overall, the Coyote missiles are an average weapon. They do deal damage, and if they are your only option, then I would definitely take them. But if I had to compare them with air-to-air rockets, I would definitely take the rocket. The only time I would take the Coyote missiles is if I wanted to dogfight somewhere in close range, such as under the trees in Hossen, where it's harder to get a lock on. Here, the Coyote missiles would excel and trump air-to-air rockets. To bring this review full circle, I would say that the Coyote missiles do not suck, but they are only an average to below average air-to-air weapon. If this video was helpful or enjoyable, feel free to hit that like button. If you want to see more videos like this or want to support the channel, click that subscribe button. This is Soapbox, signing off.